And you said it's a Stardo?
Yeah, Stardo. S-T-A-R-D-O. Yeah. Short for Stardom.
Okay. The lake yacht that is all play. And how you guys want to be pronounced? You want to be family first interview? How you guys want to be pronounced?
Lou Productions slash Family First. Design for all your lake pal.
How you guys want to be pronounced? You want to be family first? How you guys want to be pronounced?
I have to
mute that. That's Mike Angelo. This guy's Dunamis. Okay. That's Lady Impress. And I'm insane.
And I ain't on the screen. What's going on?
I told you somebody might not be on the screen. That's it.
So how y'all been doing this?
How long have we do the show? Like 3 months?
Yeah.
We had another show before.
Okay, whoever is calling, we haven't even started the show yet, so just hold on, okay?
I think our other show ran for like.
All right, guys. Okay, so you want to come over a little bit?
We have to hurry up too. Oh, it's already 7.
Yeah, I'm getting ready to start. Mm-hmm. There's people already calling in. So do you want to come over a little bit, Sean? You can come back a little bit. Everybody scoot over a little bit more.
Oh, did you want to go?
Hang on with us, guys. We're a little bit disorganized to start this show.
No, we're just running a little slow.
We're running a little bit slow. This is the Blaze NDLA show. We thank you for joining us here on video feed.
So basically, you're just going to judge off those 6 things. I'll let you know when it's that time. And other than that, we're good.
All right. So let me know, Mike Angelo, when you can situate. I think you just need to pull up some.
Okay.
But anyway, I say we start this show. Yeah? Let's do it.
We ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? We are UrbanIndieRadio.com. UrbanIndieRadio.com is the new online radio network urban independent artists and entrepreneurs have been waiting for. We feature the best up-and-coming independent music artists and entrepreneurs. Enjoy urban music 24/7 streaming live and direct to your PC as well as your tablet or smartphone. This is UrbanIndieRadio.com, your online home for new music from new artists and next in line to shine. UrbanIndieRadio.com.
All right, welcome to Blaze in the LA.
Woohoo! Blaze in the LA, we're here again in the building.
Yep. We're going to start off by getting into this first hot blazing track from MJ Parker, Didn't I Tell You?
Didn't I tell you I was the man, got the world in the palm of my hand, overcoming some hardships was a part of the plan. Maybe you don't understand, a lot of bitches expecting me to never get out of the quicksand, but I'm free from the compulsory restriction of being in the captivity of this land. The paradigm of time endowed me with a brand. So now I'm devising a way to oblige my heart's every demand. Like when you deliberate on the choice that you've made with the world in the palm of your hand. Is my heart's wants compliant with what I need to know in my head? The nuance is one that emancipates me from what makes me feel dead. Persevering past a lot of hindrances to get this bread. To get it, I've gone so many places I shouldn't have tread. When it's time to land the bed of the road, so my behavior don't say I fled. Dealing with the daily inclinations to give into the transient sensations is not what I dread. So I just demonstrate my flexibility instead. As I'm eluding these flagrant feds, didn't I tell you I don't follow the rules of the system? I've never been led. Even know I joke around. I'm not gonna stand around out of my mind. Waking up with the coffee I smell, it's a grind. As I meander around my hood, I wonder what I'll find. Guess I'm kind of circulating around like another check I signed. Don't judge me simply by my words, cause what I do for the money is not usually as kind. Just kidding, I be displaying my wit through these rhymes. Didn't I tell you I bring the mayhem when I eclipse the paradigm of time? Guess my truth is so raw, it feels like slime. Demon shot by my bullets of lines. You think the mind is poor when it's sore from hearing the bitterness of those who are in every type of way poor. But since I got the world in the palm of my hand, I'ma proceed with how I can prepare, learn, act now with a plan. Boarding my cerebral aerial plane in a class that doesn't matter because it's always a blessing when I'm over land. Didn't I tell you freedom resonates best when you're free from the compulsive restriction of being in the captivity of this land? Burning rubber on the mic with such an alive vitality that confront a band. Demolishing the attempts to make me feel devoid of hope because my ambitions are grand. MJ is more peculiar than the reasons his style kills the bland. Didn't I tell you MJ Parker is the idiosyncratic man?
The Blades in the LA Show is live and in studio right now. With your host, Insane, and Lady Impress. This is where you can get the hottest topics around the industry. What's hot and what's new? Need tips on something? Call in. Also, ladies and gentlemen, we're taking your submissions. Open mic. Wednesdays. Make sure you call in. Or you can join them in the studio. And without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome our host, Lady Impress.
Yeah. Well, come on in. Welcome to the Blazing Daily Show. I am your hostess, Lady Impress. I am Press. And thank you once again for joining us here on another Wednesday. As you guys probably already know, we have something different going on today. We are strictly webcasting. You can see us live right now by going to blazeindla.com. You can also call in if you would like. And speak with us by dialing 1-844-BLAZE-LA. That's 1-844-252-9352. This broadcast will be airing, if you miss any part of it, on Urban Indie Radio Los Angeles Sunday at 7 o'clock. So from this point forward, all our broadcasts will be airing on the radio at 7 p.m. I want to go ahead and take care of a little bit of business first. I have the book from author James Blackwell. The book of Manifest Destiny. This is Hip Hop's Untold Story by James Blackwell. Yeah. A really good read. I suggest you pick it up. You can go to Barnes & Noble, Amazon. Just Google it, Hip Hop's Untold Story. And that is our promoted event for tonight. So with that, we have a big group in the building, as you can see.
Yes.
We're going to sort of go around and get introductions. Insane?
Yep, Insane in the building as normal. We got Dunamis,
Casting Crew, Dunamis,
Michelangelo, Casting Crew. We got Lou Productions / Family First Entertainment. We gone. Let's go. We in the building. All right. We'll be right back.
What we gonna do? We got a regular lineup, or we got some changes for tonight?
Oh well, yeah. There's not gonna be a an industry topic. Right. We're gonna talk to the guests. And then other than that, we're going to do the music review and, you know, play the hot blazing tracks that are played on Urban Indie Radio.
Okay.
And that's pretty much about it for tonight. The O to the G, as we normally do.
Okay.
So
Sounds good.
Well, we're going to be right back after this short commercial break.
Newly founded record label, Insane One Records, is looking for rap, hip-hop, R&B, or gospel artists with projects already completed, including singles, EPs, or albums. We offer global distribution, artist development, social media management, publicity, and marketing. For consideration, please submit your press kit to insane1records@gmail.com, or for more information, call Insane at 951-796-1141. Insane One Records.
All right. Time to get into the bulk of the show, the music review. session. Some of these tracks have been submitted. People wanted us to check them out. I think tonight we actually have one that is a mixtape track. We normally don't do mixtape tracks, but we told them we'll do it. So we're going to throw that in there. And some of these tracks have been submitted to Insane One Records. If you want to submit, like you just heard the commercial, man, insaneonerecords@gmail.com. You know what I mean? Send your EPK or Three Hot Songs MP3 format if you ain't got that. The first song we're going to get into is Keep the Crown. We're going to be judging this off of commercial appeal, lyrical content, flow and delivery, song structure, production quality, and instrumental. Let's do it. Keep the Crown. That was Keep the Crown. I did not know the song was partly in Spanish before reviewing it, so I can't really judge on the lyrical
it's
content.
It's bilingual.
Yeah, but I don't
know
Spanish.
Judge on the English parts.
Okay, I'm going to judge on the English parts. The commercial appeal, I don't think it really has a lot of commercial appeal. As far as lyrical content, it was okay for the, you know, the English version, the parts that I knew. The flow and delivery, it could have been better. I think he could deliver it with a little bit more emphasis. As far as the song structure, I'm not sure because it sounded like it was structured right, but I'm not sure. Once again, like I said, I don't know Spanish. The production quality, it was okay. It sounded like it was mixed and mastered. The beat was okay also. So overall, it sounded like it could have been a decent song, I think. So other than that, anyway, I'll pass it around. Dudavis, what you think?
I'm gonna have to start with the lyric content. I thought it was cool, like wasn't nothing special, but it was decent though. You know, I was listening to it. The flow and delivery, like you said, it could have been better because kind of seemed like he was stumbling a little bit here and there, like he didn't really know the song. I actually thought the song structure was nice, the way he switched it up with the English and the Spanish. That's way different. But with the beat and commercial appeal, I put not applicable because that's not an original track. So I can't really judge your commercial appeal off of something that ain't yours. And then the production quality the same. Like, that's not an original beat.
What song was on? So it's not a mixtape. I mean that's a mixtape.
I never heard it before, but he's apparently heard it.
It's not an original track.
Oh, they trying to slide one in on us, huh? let me tell you people something. Don't send us mixtape music unless you absolutely specify that it's mixtape music. Because, like, in this review session, we are reviewing a mixtape song. So you're really going to, you know, not get the full effect of a review because we can't give you credit for half of the song.
Mm-hmm, that's definitely true. Stardust, what you think about that song?
Oh, man, I think the commercial appeal, he didn't really have no commercial appeal to me. You know what I mean? I didn't feel like it was... The commercial appeal, I feel like, you know, he could have did a little bit better. The lyrical content, like he said, it was in Spanish. I mean, personally, I don't know Spanish, so... I mean, it was cool, though. Like we was listening to it. The flow and delivery, I said it need to be a little polished. Like, that's what I wrote down. It need to be polished, like, mm-hmm. a little bit. You know what I mean? But he was good, though. It was real good. The song structure, like he said, it's a mixtape song, so it's like, that kind of threw me for a loop, too. Yeah. Like, I thought it was all original. Like, but if it was original, it would have been good. It would have been a cool song structure, like, the way he structured it. The production and quality, mm-hmm. it was good. The production, like if it was a actual song, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. The sound and like his voice was clear, like yeah, the production was good. The beat was super good. Like I would have loved that beat too for myself. Like if I was doing a mixtape, I would have jumped on that too. Right. So you know what I mean, it was cool.
Lady Impress.
Well, I thought until I found out that music wasn't his, that just kind of turned me down on this a little bit. Mm. But I was gonna give him a positive rating because the song sounded like it could be grand, and I also think, you know, the fact that he was doing it bilingually made it a little bit more appealing than you know, otherwise, like Dunamis was saying, it was different. And I think he had a good voice and everything, so, you know, at this point, I'm just going to say it was like a 6, a 7, and leave it at that since it wasn't, you know, his real deal.
All right. Willie Will.
The commercial appeal, I feel it appealed to a certain crowd. You know, you gotta market it to a certain crowd. The lyrical content, his flow, I mean, like I said, to a certain crowd. The flow to a certain crowd. The English part of it was cool. He flipped it, he did his thing. The flow and delivery, I mean, for, you know, whatever genre he's trying to push, his flow and delivery was decent. It wasn't all the way that, but it was decent. The structure of the song, I like how he put the, you know, the English and the Spanish together. He kind of did it for both crowds. I loved it. The production quality, it wasn't all the way there. Did need to be mastered a little bit. And the beat, like you said, it was somebody else's beat, so I can't really judge off that.
All right. Thunamis. I'm in. My kind of
job. He's a little bit darker.
Don't start none.
Hey, but I'm going to say, overall, commercial appeal, I don't think that's a song for the commercial appeal. It's just like, I would rate that as a Spanish song, just because everybody understands English, but only certain few understand Spanish. Lyrical content, it was okay. Flow of delivery, I think, like Will said, he need to hit the pockets better. The song structure was cool for the switch up as far as the English and the Spanish. The production quality was okay. You know what I mean? The beat could have been a little bit tighter. And as far as number 6, the beat, I gave it like a 5. I gave the beat like a 5. The production quality was cool, but the beat, gave it a 5.
Yeah, I completely agree. You know what? This is our first show off the Blog Talk Radio dashboard, and actually I gave out a number for callers to call, and I see we've had 3 callers. I'm actually having to use my cell phone for this show instead of my own phone here. So I'm going to see, do I have somebody on the line right now? Can you hear me, caller? Hello, caller, can you hear me?
All right, we'll just come back with the callers after the music review. That's when you guys are supposed to call in. That's why we put around 7:30. After the music review, that's when we take the callers, because right now we're in the middle of the music review. So call back.
Okay. Mm-hmm. They're still actually 844 on.
844-BLAZE-LA. That's the number. The next track we're going to get into is Grim on the Deck. I mean, Grim on Deck.
White.
don't know how long that song was. I was trying to figure it out because the outro of the song is long. Can you tell me how long the song is?
No, I can't.
Okay. Well, I thought the song was going off. Yeah, I know. I noticed it was two verses. I thought it was going off, and then I thought it was coming on, and then I guess it was going off again. So there's something wrong with that, and your songs need to be three verses, so that automatically is knocking your song down right now. The song had good commercial appeal as far as being on the radio, if it didn't have but it had the cuss words and it had the cuz in it too many times, so that's going to keep it from being on the radio. But if it was clean edited, but I did like the song. I actually did like the song. The lyrical content was good. The flow and delivery was good. The beat was good. The production quality was good. The beat was good. He sounded like Bun B. You know what I mean? Right. And, you know, the beat could have used a little bit more instruments in the background of it to bring out the effect of the beat more, but it was still a decent beat. It was still a good beat. And the flow had a good vibe through it. It rode that wave. It was just too short in that ending. I don't know. I could tell that it wasn't full. The song wasn't finished. So there was another verse that was supposed to be on the song, but he didn't. He just sent it in like that.
Right.
Don't send in halfway stuff. Come with your A game. That's all I got to say. Startup, what you think?
Oh, yeah. I feel like the commercial appeal, he got potential. Like, it's a lot of people, like Willie said, it's a lot of people like in this area that might gravitate to that. You know what I mean? Like, the lyrical content, it was cool. It was cool. He did do a lot of, you know what I mean, gang banging, but you know, it works sometimes. Like, you know what I mean? YG doing it. Like, it's a lot of us doing it. You know what I mean? So I feel like the flow and delivery, he got potential. Like, give him a year in the studio, like a year in just in the studio, he gonna polish. Like, he gonna be something. Like, I can hear it. Like, I can hear him trying to punch lines and, like, you know what I mean? He's dope. Like, he's real dope.
Yeah.
The song structure, it was cool. It was pretty cool. It was cool, you know. Production quality, the production quality was straight. It was straight. Like, as long as I can hear you, you know what I mean? And you clear and you, like, even with the beat and you riding the beat, it's good. It's good. The beat was dope to me. The beat was dope.
Right. Mike Angelo?
Commercial appeal, I would say no. But lyrical content was pretty good. It was a trap song. It was one of them getting paper songs. Mm-hmm. Dirty South, you know what I'm saying? Club bangers. You know what I mean? Flow and delivery, it was on in pocket for what type of song it was. You know what I mean? He ain't lyrical miracle, but he was spitting. You know what I'm saying? Song structure, I like the way it was, but he left a shorter verse. And then you just let the beat ride out. You left a shorter verse, man. Send three verses, like Empress said. Production quality was pretty tight. And the beat, I like the style of the beat. It was like something to ride to. So it was a good song. I give it a 7.
All right. Willie Will.
At a commercial appeal, I feel it was for the streets. You know, it was for the streets all the way. You know, the lyrical content of the song, it was cool. I was waiting for, like, the punchlines was there. Everything was cool, but I was waiting for kind of more, you know,
spitting
savviness to it.
Yeah.
His flow and delivery, it was basic. I was waiting for a switch up. He came the same on both verses. He could have switched it up a little bit. Third verse, he could have murked it, went in, that's where you had to go hard at. The song structure, I like the format though. He had the little hook. The hook was right, you know, the format was cool. The production quality was there. It was there. And the beat, it was even. It could, like you said, could add some more sound to it, could add some more slap to it. But it was even for the most part.
All right, Dunamis.
You know what? I actually liked the song. I was over here, my head was bobbing. Like, I'm saying, like, I'm from the Midwest, so, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, that's something I would ride to. Like, for real, you know, the lyrical content, it was there for, like Mike Ann said, that type of song. You know, every song ain't got to be sounding like Common to somebody. The flow and delivery, I'm used to that down south music. He sounds straight out of Texas or something. Mm-hmm. The song structure, I liked it, the way he switched up through the chopped and screwed in there. The production quality, you could tell they actually got that mix somewhere. You know what I'm saying? It ain't sound all airy, and the beat was banging to me, so I liked it.
Mm-hmm. All right, callers, don't forget you got to call in. We'll let you speak after the music review session. 844-BLA-ZELA or 252-9352. Lady Empress, what do you think about that?
and we will let you speak as soon as I figure out how to bring you in on this conference, okay? So please bear with us. I like the song. I felt like it was an underground song, and it had good appeal for the underground. I could hear it playing on in our cars, and with a little bit of tweaking, like you guys have already pointed out, it could be made more commercial, and I think that could actually really be a good song with the additions that you guys have already talked about.
You gotta throw another verse up
you
on
that. You gotta throw another verse. You gotta get a little bit of more effects here and there on the song.
On the beat, could have used it. The beat was good, but it could have been better. There could have been some more instruments. It was a little bit, you know, it wasn't that intriguing, that audio lyrical caught you like, ooh, bump, 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 super bump. Yeah, you know what I mean?
Even if you don't throw a whole verse in there, like, even if you threw
a bridge.
Yeah, like, something. Like, you switch it up, make it a little bit longer.
Switch it up at the end, come with a different something, like,
even if it ain't the 16th, throw a half, throw an 8 up in there, something. But we're gonna do this other song naked. Come on, we're gonna shoot it up and see what it does.
Oh, you went out of order.
Don't matter.
It wasn't naked?
Well, it matters when I have to find it on the thing. Here we go.
That wasn't naked.
Naked. And everybody gotta get naked.
All right.
All right, that was Naked. Man, was that naked. Was a banger. I ain't gonna lie. Everything was good on that song.
We ain't naked, though.
I wrote down I wrote down good all the way across the board. Yeah. That don't happen too much on you know what I'm saying? Sometimes we have two or three songs that everything was good. But I don't know if that was sent there for Music Review or the label. If it was sent there for the label, I'd be wanting to hear some more music from it. If it was sent there for Music Review, man, that's dope. That's a hit. That, you know, everything good. The production quality, the lyrical content, the flow and delivery, song structure, the beat, everything. The production quality. I mean, it was all good.
Even to heighten the cuss words. I love it, man. Like, that's how you get your stuff played, bro. Mm-hmm. Keep doing like that. Those out there listening, that's how you get your stuff played. Three nice verses in pocket. Mm-hmm. He's spitting. He in pocket. He doing his thing. The beat is... you know, compliment his lyrics. It was dope. I gave it a 9.5.
Real close. It was in pocket. The whole it kept the hook. The whole song.
I want to see how he do the video though. Yeah. But the video, what's gonna happen is the video gonna really sell it because everybody want to see how he gonna pull it off.
Yeah, because that was illustrated. It was like Tupac said. You know, paint that perfect picture.
Oh yeah.
All right, Dunamis.
Man, I agree. Two thumbs up, man. Like, that'll go in the club. Like, you can play that behind any song they playing right now. Right. And as long as they mix it in and not announce this new music, the party not going to stop. It's not going to stop.
Right.
Especially if it's hot. What?
You don't got to have a 2-drink minimum for that song.
You can party to that song.
You can party and rock it.
Will it will.
It was a go up track, man. I really liked the track. You know, he did his thing on that. You know, the lyrical content, he was on point. Like, for that, for the whole, you know, structure of the song. The flow and delivery was all the way dip. Like, you know, I'm from the Bay, so I like dip shit. Mm-hmm. It was dip. But the production quality was dope. It was dope. Whoever cut his cuss words out and the whole thing, they went in on that. Yeah. The beat, it was my type of track, you feel me? I like how the beat dropped. I like how, you feel me, it came back in. The 808s was probably slapping like a motherfucker on there. So, that's it. I love it. It was a dope track.
It got that thump. All right, start off.
Yeah, it was dope. It was definitely commercial. It's now. Like, that's the now sound. Like, for now, like, that's going in the club. That's going to make the ladies dance. That's going to make everybody get on the floor.
Right.
The only thing is, there's other words that you could use too as far as the cuss words part. Like, you could have, you know what I mean, put something else in there. But other than that, it's a hit, bro. Yeah. So, you know what I mean? Like, the cuss words, that's the only thing I was on because it'll take a lot out of the song. Like,
say that.
We really want to hear what you're trying to say. You know what I mean?
But
there's other words you could use to put in them places. But other than that, it's a stupid hit, bro.
It was good though. He did that as far as making it, you know, for his commercial, you know, just taking it out. But you could tell even if he switched the words, it was still gonna be a hit. It's like my nigga, you know, well, my nigga's my hitter. Same thing. It's the same thing. Lady Empress, what you think about that?
No, I totally agree. I just also think that he could have done something better than what he did with those faded out B words. Just
for radio, but as far as the song,
the song is a banger.
Yeah, the song is a hit, but I'm just saying he needs to fix that.
As far as the radio.
For the radio.
Yeah, for commercial appeal.
That's the only thing, because you shouldn't even send anybody, because that really detracted a little bit from the song. It kind of took your mind off of it for a second. But I agree, the song is absolutely a good song. And I'll go ahead and say that Sonny De Niro, and the name of the song was Naked.
Because
it was a hit. If it was crap, I wouldn't say your name.
Let me clear that up because we used to say the artist names, but some people we was actually getting like threats because we were judging people's music, so we stopped using people's name and we just mentioned the name of the song now instead of the artist. That way your feelings ain't gotta get hurt. Yeah. You know what I mean?
We don't take y'all music, y'all send it to us.
That's true.
I mean, all right. Constructive criticism. You know what I mean? You got to be able to take that as an artist too. Like me, I love it. You know what I mean? Like whatever. You know what I mean? Like judge.
This
me.
Is the Blaze and the LA show.
And we're gonna keep it real. We're gonna tell you the
truth.
Don't
come up in here if you're not ready to get blazed.
All right. This next song is a mixtape track. So if the verses aren't as long or the music, it's a mixtape track. Okay. So we're just gonna judge it off of just off
fair
the song. It's not an album song.
Fair one.
And I want the callers to, if you can hear me, please hang on and please mute your phone because I can actually hear you coming through. So I'm gonna try and pick you up after this last song, okay? And the name of the song is
What That Shit Do.
Mixtapes. that's what that shit do. Taylor Supreme, what that shit do. When I pull up on your bitch, I'm like, what that shit do? Whole team behind me, I'm like, what that shit do? When I'm mobbing downtown, I'm like, what that shit do? What that shit do? What that shit do? When I pull up on your bitch, I'm like, what that shit do? Whole team behind me, I'm like, what that shit do? When I'm mobbing downtown, I'm like, what that shit do? What that shit do? What that shit do? What that shit do? It's the question, I'ma answer it. When I'm with your chick and you call, best she cancel it. So much booty, girl, it's hard for me to handle it. Fruity and the Swiss blend. Tastes like some Mandarin. Got a loud pack, we sound like chattering. High end drunk, so when I walk, I start staggering. Them hoes thick, work team start clapping it. Dick so long, need a ladder just to straddle it. Dick you down, but I'ma keep my last name. Subway fresh, touch the bread like mayonnaise. Always keep rubber, so I only go with plan A. Niggas keep bugging, fucking around and get their fans sprayed. And my team check niggas like my fan page. House full of hoes with the bros at the man cave. Only smoking good, the Swisher is great. Man, we be burning pounds like we trying to lose weight, okay? When I pull up on your bitch, I'm like, what that shit do? Whole team behind me, I'm like, what that shit do? When I'm mobbing downtown, I'm like, what that shit do? What that shit do? What that shit do? When I pull up on your bitch, I'm like, what that shit do? Whole team behind me, I'm like, what that shit do? When I'm mobbing downtown, I'm like, what that shit do? What that shit do? What that shit do? I'm a motherfucking fool again, money is nothing to me. Got a zip of some gooey, these hoes throwing that coochie. I'm about to pop me a roofie. Click fresher than sushi. Your girl popping the booty. I got a rock in the movement. Hop in the whip, now I'm cruising. Get on the gas and I'm zooming like. I'm trying to get off this work. My shirt smelling like burp. I'm making twerk till she hurt. You can step up and get murked. Like, what that shit do? My whole team behind me. I'm like, go get your crew. We gon' show you what it's like when gorillas get loose. I got some gay in the coupe. Bad stack to the roof. And I be rolling up loud. Y'all be smoking on mute. A couple hundred for my shoes. Swag fresher than June. I'm the man on the moon. Blowing clouds like monsoon. New Maserati, and I just cop two. I be whipping around the hood like, what that shit do? When I pull up on your bitch, I'm like, what that shit do? Whole team behind me, I'm like, what that shit do? When I'm mobbing downtown, I'm like, what that shit do? What that shit do? What that shit do? When I pull up on your bitch, I'm like, what that shit do? Whole team behind me, I'm like, what that shit do? When I'm mobbing downtown, I'm like, what that shit do? What that shit do? What that shit do? If you got a fat ass ring, what that shit do? If you down to strip some gas, scream, what that shit do? If you know your team real, scream, what that shit do? What that shit do? What that shit do? If you got a bad bitch, scream, what that shit do? If you smoking top shelf, scream, what that shit do? If you fucking with the click, scream, what that shit do? What that shit do? What that shit do?
All right.
Oh, that was what that shit do.
I think that the song is well, of course, it's definitely, it's a mixtape song. It's definitely a street song, you know what I mean? Because it is gutter. Yeah. But other than that, I did actually like the song. I really like the lyrical content. You can tell that they put some effort into the song, just like the last artist. The flow and delivery. I like the flow and delivery also. It sounded good to me. It kept me intrigued. It was nice. The song structure was good. You know, it kept me listening. It kept me going. The production quality was good. The beat, you know, it was a mixtape, but the beat was cool. You know, the beat, it's a nice beat, of course. Exactly. And the song overall was good.
Yeah.
So. Dunamis.
You know what?
Uh-oh, he smiled.
The song was better than I thought it was going to be at the heard of the title. And I was actually digging it at first. But I listened to lyrics, and I listened to every word. He talking about popping roofies and stuff? After I heard that, I couldn't really listen to the rest.
I did hear that part in there, but I mean, hey.
It was cool, but like I said, I listened to everything. So, like, he lost me after that. It was kind of hard to, like, get me back. When he got talking about it, that's a date rape drug? And people like, come on, be serious, man.
He said y'all was smoking on low. Y'all was smoking on mute. He was smoking on loud.
He had some punchlines in there. He lost me with that. That's good. When you hear a song and you remember lines right out of it, it don't get lost you by it. That's good. That's
now,
good.
It's also a live song. Like if they want to perform at a club, it's a trap music that, you know,
I liked it, man. It was pretty cool for what it was.
Live performance, because I actually know the person that sent this song in, right. And they do actually perform that song. And when they do, it does get the people.
But you know what? Everything ain't gonna be lyrical, man. It's not. It's like we. You know,
but it ain't gotta be lyrical, bro. It's but certain stuff I just can't dig.
It's for the song though. Yeah, the club, the trap. That's what they doing. You know, I mean, you know what I'm saying? Not disrespecting what you said, but I'm just saying, that's what I got from the song is trapping. It's a mixtape. You know, he doing his thing. All right, I liked it.
Why it's six of us here. That's gonna judge it. Right. I like the start off.
Oh, yeah, it was dope. I feel like it was dope. Like, you know what I mean? I feel like the commercial appeal, everything was dope to me. Like, the lyrical content, I liked it. It was pretty dope. Like, it's now. You know what I mean? That's the now sound. Like, that's the now sound for these teens. That's the now sound for high school.
Yeah, that makes sense. Because what he said makes sense. Right. That song for the demographics, mostly younger people would listen to that. Right. Older people wouldn't really get, like, the older crowd wouldn't really get a vibe.
Maybe that's what, David, you know, our song, our music ain't for everybody. That just wasn't mine.
But you know how it is in the club. Eventually you're going to like it. Yeah. If you hear it a couple times, that's a two-dream minimum for me. You know, the hook was more. The hook kept you into it, though. He can do it for the crowd, and eventually you're going to like the song.
What you think about that track?
Hey, the song was cool, though. It was a club banger, you know, for the mixtape part of it, you know. The little content, you know, what that shit do. They was on that shit. Like, the floor delivery, it was solid for the song.
Right.
The structure of the song, it was cool. It was cool. I like how they did the little voice changer and the whole little situation. Let's see. The production quality, it was mixtape. It was there. Like, you know, you can't really get the full quality with a mixtape track. The beat, it was mixtape. So, you feel me? Same thing.
Yep. Lady Empress.
What it do?
You know what?
What you thinking?
Clit fresher than sushi. I'm like, what the heck?
Hey. You remember that?
I don't know what you...
Sure did. Wrote it down.
I don't know what you've been eating on. Anyway.
I don't know what you've been eating
on. I like the song, but as a radio programmer, even though I play completely explicit music on my radio station, I would reject that. Because it's too pornographic, really.
Nah, that song wasn't too pornographic. Not to compare it to some of the... It wasn't too bad.
Well, I'm just saying, I probably would reject it because I have a thing. If you send me a song that only talks about the sex you had last night, how long your ladder is, or what like that, that's appealing to a certain segment, but not to a mass segment.
That's true.
It's a little bit too pornographic in its current state.
That's true, but
but because it's a mixtape song, number one, it shouldn't even be coming on my radio. But I'm just saying, you know, you don't have to be that filthy. That's, you know, I like the songs, don't get me wrong, but I think it's just, you know, it's just a little bit too filthy.
And I think that you, like I just said, I think from the demographics of it, I don't mind the filthiness.
Well, I don't mind some of the filthiness,
now,
too.
Now, you being a woman and being a little bit older than me, I think that's where you have to draw. You can't draw a line when you're going as far as this music.
No. This is like maybe because it's a man thing, maybe because, you know, but I'm just saying I like the song too, but some of the stuff was just a little bit too filthy. You don't really have to go that far to gain a crowd. I mean, you don't really have to go to that level. Like when we listen to songs and we say, "Hey, that really had no lyrical content." This really doesn't have that great of lyrical content either, even though it rhymed, the lyrical content is actually not on the college level.
Besides the roofie part and that part that you said about the clit and all that kind of stuff, besides that, I think it was going, those points stood out. They were trying to make the songs, I could see what they were trying to do. Right. I know what, because I used to be an artist, so they were trying to make it sound out. They were trying to come with something that was going to catch you. That's why they wrote it down. That's why you remember
it. And if I was in the club, I would have probably been dancing to it, weaving and bobbing. But what I'm saying is, commercial appeal, no. because you're not gonna sell that. You're not gonna.
It's,
you know,
mixtape music.
I know
it's
what
not
I'm saying.
For sale.
But what I'm saying, mm-hmm, that music was mixtape music. Their lyrics, are their lyrics correct, or are they singing
somebody
else's
lyrics? Yes, no, the
lyrics
are their lyrics. Lyrics.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So, you know, that's my opinion. I'm sticking to it.
Everybody has.
All right. Everybody has their opinion. Okay. Well, anyways, what
can
about
I,
the callers?
You know what? I had to sit on the phone because the callers, I can hear they're listening to us on there.
We're using a different phone brand this one than we normally use because Blog Talk Radio had been hacked in a couple times and their stuff was choppy. So this is the first time we're using this.
And
sorry for all the problems, everybody.
Yes. Okay. So is there a caller on the line that can hear me? Please.
Caller.
Okay.
We're going to skip the callers.
No, I heard them.
You
wanna
say what?
I can hear you. Go ahead. Who is this?
This is Ivy the Artist.
Oh, I'm the artist.
Oh, IB?
The artist.
All right.
Did we play one of your tracks tonight?
No, actually, I'm not. I don't do much of a speaking. I'm a visual artist. I'm a tattoo artist, actually.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Okay, cool. Did any of these songs we played in the review session strike you as hits?
Can you repeat that part, please?
Did any of the songs you've heard so far in that review session strike you as hits or?
That's all of them. All of them have their own uniqueness to it. I enjoy listening to all of them.
Oh.
From what I heard from, you know, what I on my end of the phone. But, you know what I mean? They all have, you can make it really.
Oh, okay, cool. Thank you.
Looking.
Is there anything you wanted to tell our listeners? Are you an artist as well, or?
No, actually like a visual artist. I do more drawings.
Oh, okay.
More drawings than everything. I'm a tattoo artist. Yeah, I mean, got a whole little tattoo
squad.
Okay,
NBA
cool.
Tattoo official.
Well, thank you for tuning in.
Market DCEO, in-game president.
Oh, okay.
Artist, you know what I mean?
That's good. We appreciate you calling in and watching us. Are you watching us on the video feed?
No, actually, no. I'm actually live on my phone right now in my shop.
Oh, okay. Good looking. Thank you so much for calling in, okay? And you know, call me back at a later date. We'll talk about getting you some advertisements on this show. Okay? Got to do a little business. All right. Thank you. Bye bye. All right. Let me see. Hold on. I think I just hung up on everybody else. Okay. Whoops. Sorry. call
right,
back.
We'll be right back after this second hot track featured on Urban Indie Radio.
This is
Ruby with Runaway.
Runway.
So damn it.
All right, that was, let me find my notes, Ruby with Runway. Sorry, we've been a little busy here. All right, we have another caller on the line.
Yes, go ahead, caller. You're live on the Blazing DLA show.
What up?
Hello.
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 Yes, we can.
Hey, I see you guys live streaming right here. I'm enjoying what I see.
Who's this? Who is this?
Thank you.
Yeah, who is this?
Hello?
Yes. Who are you?
My name is Sharai. I'm in the IE.
Oh, cool. Right. Thank you, Sharai. What's up, Sharai? We appreciate it.
Indian Empire love.
You're looking now.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Anything you want to let us know? Let my listeners know?
Actually, yeah, I'm enjoying the show. I like the fact that the constructed
are you still there?
I'm sorry, Shirai.
I'm so sorry. I'm just learning how to do this. I'm so sorry. Stay on hold. We'll be back. Let's get into our in studio guests.
Yes, we're having a lot of technical difficulties tonight. All right, in studio guests, we got Lil Productions and Family First Entertainment in the building. Let's
go. So who's
want to speak first on the behalf of Lou Productions
Family
and Family First.
First?
Since you guys are telling you, you're gonna have to give us the whole rundown on this.
Hey, hey.
All right, so we have Lou Productions taking the chairs and Family First Entertainment, Willie Will, and Stardo, who participated in our music review session. So let's get into Miss Lou.
Hey, how are you, Queen?
I'm doing fine, Queen.
Awesome. Thank you for having us here.
I'm glad you guys decided to come back and visit us again and brought some new folks for us to meet. This is awesome.
Yes, definitely. Our partners here, you know, we done merged together, brought two powerful entities in the IE together and just making noise out here and just trying to provide platforms for artists to display their gifts and talents. That's what we all about, you know what I'm saying? Just
absolutely
making a way.
Absolutely. Yes. So how long y'all been doing what you do?
Lou Productions, we actually been doing since 2006. Family First can speak to how long they've been doing anything, but we actually been together for a couple of months now.
Okay.
As one. So and things has been progressing and moving, and we just working. We out here trying to get it. It's like everybody else, you know.
Absolutely.
And stay relevant. And that's what it's all about in this game. You gotta stay relevant.
Stay relevant.
Sure, right.
Sir.
Yes.
Welcome to the Blazing DLA show.
Yes, I'm the marketing director for Lou Productions.
And so, your name is?
I'm Darrell.
Darrell. That's Darrell, everybody. No, say no, hi. No, wave no, to no, all the up, folks girl? Listening and looking.
We getting it. So, I'm here to support my team.
Absolutely.
Family First.
Yeah.
Y'all did a great job.
Yeah, you guys did.
So,
yeah,
we appreciate it.
That was good. That was good.
We appreciate y'all coming, too.
Really, we're going to speak about some events we got coming up.
Oh, so it sounds good. Let us know.
Actually, what the first thing you want to talk about, the fashion show?
Yes, we are actually doing our annual Urban Hip Hop R&B fashion show. Yes, we are. It's open to everybody. You know what I'm saying? We want performers to get on and models. It's a family event. It's open to the community. You know, especially out here, especially with everything that's going on, you need something like that. It's, you know, they talk about hip hop, they talk about rap, and they shun down, you know, on that. And we got to provide different things in the community just to bring our people together and let them know, hey, you know, turn up and have a good time.
Yeah, we came to the last one.
Yes, yes. Thank you guys so much. And you guys are going to be a part of the festivities this year, be a big force behind that. So we're definitely looking for, like I said, models, vendor sponsorship, only $60. Your logo go on our Step and Repeat banner, vendors. So this is the opportunity for fashion designers to, you know, display their apparel, you know what I mean? Right. So it's a lot of them out there. So come on, you know, log on to Blue Productions and definitely and just sign up and be a part of what we got going on.
Get Sam Bernardino going on. We got our late night spotlight coming up this Friday.
Yes, yes. Featuring the Hard Hitter Boys from Family
First. From Family First. Sunday we have our pay to perform out of the, in the Empire nightclub. That'll be Family First thing. So it's free all night. So come out and just pack it out and enjoy yourselves.
In that event, we just want to say that it's a special event to us because a lot of times these artists go out here and they give their last dollar just, you know what I'm saying? We're actually paying artists, you know what I'm saying, camps. We're featuring camps.
That is extremely unique.
I just posted about that on Facebook earlier.
Thank you. So artists, you can get paid to perform.
Camps. It's got to be a camp. And when we say a camp, you know, you got to have an R&B artist up in there. We just don't want just, you know, all rap, you know what I'm saying? So definitely got to mix it up. And then we have our live TV show that we're doing March the 25th, where we bring an artist on. Some of the same, similar to the same things that you're doing, Queen. We have our reggae nights every last Thursday. So, oh, and our big event, our all-white masquerade hip-hop R&B yacht events, yes. Because, like I said, we're trying, you know, Blue Productions stands for Launching Unique Entertainment. We're trying to hit them in every direction. You know what I'm saying? It's cool. Everybody can go get a club and do something. But let's, you know, think big. We think big. You know what I'm saying? So we on the yacht. Bring your all white. Bring your masquerade. You know, mask.
Gonna
and
that's
going to
be big.
It's only 300
bring
people.
Bring your budget.
And we do have tickets available online on the Eventbrite. Just look Blue Productions Family First. You'll see it definitely.
Get us on Facebook. We have our tickets for you too.
Yes, we have a barbecue too, a fundraiser we're doing this Saturday in the IE. You know what I'm saying? We're going hard out here, you guys.
So you have events Friday, Saturday, and Sunday?
Yes, yeah, we working. We ain't playing.
Okay, give one main place where our listeners can go. Is it LouProductions.com or give one where they can sort of find everything?
Yes, you can actually look on our website. That's www.louproductions.com, and it'll have our up-and-coming events. Okay. So please check us out. Get involved. Please get involved.
It's the community. We out here doing it for y'all, too.
Yeah,
we need y'all out here. We need the support to keep it going.
Absolutely.
And we're going to keep it going, regardless.
L.A. to the I.E., that's how we do it. Blaze in the L.A. Mm-hmm.
Now, we have a track here that we're going to play. You also manage artists? Or?
Yes, ma'am. I certainly do. Yes, King.
Yes.
I certainly do. I manage the Speaker Junkies. They were here last month. Thank you for having them. Yeah, and also manage Paul Douglas, which is a great artist. Lyrical. He just, definitely.
I'm familiar with Paul Douglas.
Yeah, so we do a lot. Loop Productions, we do live music. I mean, we deal with bands. We help artists.
Models,
everything. All aspects of the entertainment. That's what we do.
I like models.
Yeah. I bet. So, yes, Kings. You guys can be in the fashion show, please. It's an urban fashion show and all that and the other. I'm serious, so just get at us. You know what I'm saying? We got to come together, you know?
And Urban Stars Media in St. Juan will be in the house on Sunday.
Yes, at Empire Nightclub.
At Empire Nightclub. And then also we'll be joining them for the May Fashion Affair.
Yes. Sunday, May 18th. May 18th. We got tickets. Get them tickets.
Let's go ahead and hear this track. We have a track from one of your artists, Paul Douglas. Okay.
Douglas, what's up, baby?
And this is called Euphoria Mix.
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Let's take a listen to it.
Paul Douglas.
Yeah. Blue Productions.
I'm mad because he didn't come up here. Where's
that,
he at?
That goes. That goes. I know he has some.
I understand.
But we gonna be working.
Paul, I got to holler at you.
Yes.
The only reason I didn't get up and start dancing is I made too much noise. I'm over here like, what?
And that's why you have a happy studio
right here.
It makes you
Commercial appeal.
I had no
lyrical content, flow delivery, so all A plus, bro. That's a hit, bro. That's a banger.
I'm talking to y'all. Paul, that's a banger.
Shout out to Paul. That's a banger, Paul. Wow.
Just give me a shout out.
We just seen
him.
I love that. That's beautiful.
Well, maybe we'll do a Sunday. Have him do a Sunday.
Oh, that would be nice. I'll come out with my
Paul, you hear that? You listening Sunday.
Good job, Paul. Like that song.
Yeah, man. That was nice. That was nice, bro.
All right.
That's what I sometimes I say. A lot
of artists make songs, man. Sometimes you got to make hits. That's nobody hit. Remembers you by songs. People only say, "Hey, you remember Whoop the Whoop by what?" Because they make by that hit.
That's classic. You'll be praying that at barbecues for the next 30 years.
Two-stepping Stacey Adams.
And Queen, you like how he was vulgar a little bit,
But it was important. I was going to say that.
Come on, let's try.
All right, let's cross our fingers. Caller, is there? Can you hear me?
Hello, caller.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Is, who's this?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am. I can.
Hey, I just want to give a shout out to Lou Productions. That last song was
awesome. You know it. You know it. Shout out Lou Productions. Shout out Family First. Yeah, y'all gonna switch. Y'all can actually switch now. Absolutely.
They're amazing. And I just want to give them a big shout out. And I have a question. If someone was interested in becoming part of your team, how would they go about getting on board?
Are you mean coming be a part of the Lou Productions team?
Yes, ma'am.
You know what? You need to go to louproductions.com. And at listen for the end of the show, we're going to give you how to connect. We'll give you how to connect with them at the end of the show.
567-1000.
All right. Thank you so much for calling.
You're welcome. Thank you.
All righty. I'm going to try and swap a call. Caller, can you hear me?
Yeah, it's me, MJ Parker. I think you guys played my song, didn't I tell you?
Yep. Yes, sir.
MJ Parker.
How you doing?
Okay. I'm doing great. I guess I missed it. I kind of got off my shift at work, you know.
you started off our show.
Yeah, we started off the show with you, actually. Your track was featured. Thank you so much for putting it on Urban Indie Radio LA. And if you missed it, after we're done with this show, you'll be able to see the video stream at blazeindiela.com. And then you can see it, catch it all week. And again, this show will also be airing on Urban Indie Radio LA on Sunday at 7 p.m. Okay?
And you can catch it on Blog Talk and iTunes.
Yeah, you're on iTunes, you're on Blog Talk, you're on everywhere. That's why people should come to the Blaze Indie LA show. It is the go-to show to get exposure. All right. Thank you so much, MJ.
Say that.
Did you guys like it, though?
Yeah, it was hot. We started off the show with it.
Okay, great. I'm just I'm sure if you introduce a lot of people to it, they will dig it. I'm just trying to, you know, just change the world a spin at a time. I believe in y'all. I like what y'all do, and I definitely want to work more with y'all in the future. For sure.
You can holler at me. I do artist development, 951-796-1141, because there was a couple of flaws in that song. Holler at me. I'm going to tell you about it.
Okay, thank you. I think I cut MJ off. I'm so sorry. Next caller, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Hi, who's this? I'm sorry, say that again.
My name's Nikki.
Hi, Nikki. How are you? Thank you for calling into the Blaze Indie LA show. Are you watching us live on video feed?
No, I've been calling, so I've just been waiting.
Are you calling to support artists?
Yes.
Which artists?
I'm calling to support Willie Will and the Family First Camp.
I'm so sorry that you had a tough time getting in. We actually have had probably about 20 callers, and I'm so sorry, but I thank you for calling and being patient enough to stick with me until I was able to get you on. And please, you know, continue to support these artists and the Blaze Indie LA show. Thank you so much.
All right. We'll try to get back with more callers because we're having some technical difficulties still.
Well, we're getting it in. Mm-hmm. I just hung up on everybody else again. So sorry. That's
what I'm saying. Anyway, Family First, tell us a little bit about you guys, you know, Family First Entertainment. Let us know a little something.
Where we start?
Start in the beginning. How long y'all been doing this? You know what I'm saying? What you, make sure you give your shout outs and what you're trying to, you know, portray. What do you want us to know? You talking live to everybody.
Okay, as far as music, we actually been doing it for about 10 years now. You know what I mean? As far as Family First go, we've been doing this since about 2008. You know what I mean? We really like branched together. Like I had a group with, because this is my cousin. Like it's really family. You know what I mean? It's like family based. So his older brothers and I have a group called Retro 80s. We was called 80s Babies, like back in the day. So the Hard Hitter Boys and the Retro 80s, we came together and we formed Family First. You know what I mean? So
that's
what it is to this day. We've been pushing since like 2008, just getting all our paperwork done, making sure we write so when we hit these streets, we can go hard as we want to. You know what I mean?
That's important. Make sure you understand that paperwork. The business side of the music game is important. Contracts, business.
So aside from your merger with Loop Productions, do you have anything else? Are you making songs yourself?
We're artists within ourselves.
Right.
We actually have two different groups. We got the Retro 80s. We got the Hard Hitter Boys together. We make Family First Entertainment. We working on our upcoming projects. We looking to drop new singles in the future, in the near future. We just been working. It's a lot of work we've been doing. We've been throwing events. We've been doing everything. Everything that needs to be done as an artist, on the other hand, as a business person, we trying to take care of that because we do CEO the label.
Right.
So, we, you know, at the same time, it's work. And then, you know, we try to be artists at the same time. So, you know, we juggling it. We juggling it, but we making it work, though.
That's good to know. All right, so how can people follow you and your music, your group's music, quickly?
You can find me on Facebook, Max Stardo, Instagram, Retro Stardo. And you can find us on Facebook at Family First CNT. Go like our page. And, I mean, you can find the Hard Hitter Boys on Facebook at Hard Hitter Boys. Like, you go like their page. Willie Will Jones.
Yeah. Willie Will Jones on Facebook. Willie Will, FFMGRD on Twitter. You know, follow me on Twitter. I'm everywhere. I'm in the streets. The IE is our home base, so we finna shut the E down. So,
we coming.
So,
let's
do it.
All right. Thank you guys so much
for
being here tonight. And anytime you know you got some hot coming up, let us know. Come back. We'll be glad to have you back on the show.
Family First, y'all.
Family First. And Lou Productions. And they got something going on every day this weekend. There is no excuse. Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
All right.
Get to that barbecue.
Let's get into this third hot track. If you want to get your track spun on Urban Indie Radio, and yes, we do pay royalties. We got our paperwork.
Oh, that's great.
This is Da Force with a song called Baller on Top. Baller on Top.
This is for you, do what it do. I'ma chatter back up as I come through. Force dogs chilling. Force dogs what? Force dogs massive. That's what's up. Y'all wanna play games? Time to grow up. This lane's too fast for you. Time to slow up. Bang that harmony. Bang that chamber. Click to the clack. Bang that hammer. Force dog. It's up in the building. Everybody, let's hear some noise.
You don't wanna sit and make it to the top. You don't wanna sit and make it to the top. You don't wanna sit and make it to the top. I can't stop, I won't drop. You don't wanna sit and make it to the top. You don't wanna sit and make it to the top. You don't wanna sit and make it to the top. I can't stop, I won't drop. You don't wanna sit and make it to the top. I can't stop, I won't drop. You don't wanna see me get to the top.
All right, that was The Force with Baller on Top.
Thank you so much for putting your songs on Urban Indie Radio Los Angeles. When you do that, you do get featured here on the Blaze Indie LA show as well. So it's all types of good exposure, plus we pay royalties.
All right, well, we're getting down to the end of that show right now. And best thing, get some shout-outs. You can catch me on, well, just Google me. You're going to find me. Insane One Records, insaneonerecords.com. You know what I'm saying? I'm on Instagram, Facebook. I'm going to have to redo my LinkedIn and Twitter. But go ahead and holler at your boy. Check out what we're doing. You know what I mean? We're looking for artists to sign. We do distribution plus publicity deals. I mean, so we are owned by Urban Stars Media. So
I am Urban Stars Media.
And then also, if you need artist development, like I was mentioning earlier, holler at me, 951-796-1141, or email me, insaneonerecords@gmail.com. Send in them submissions, too. That's it.
Yo, shout out to Chi-Town IE. Be on the lookout for my mixtape Masterpiece and my mixtape Saturday night, Sunday morning with my boy Dunamis. Yes. Family First. Yeah, yeah. Urban Indie Radio fam, and I'm
out.
Yes,
yes. Do it. What
Dunamis. Shout out to Turn Max, GNC Media. We're going to be down at City Walk on the 24th, man. We finna go blow it up down there. And my album will be officially live in stores. Give me like another 2 days. I ain't know it's going to take a lot to upload. It'll take like 72 hours, but y'all will get the link, though. You check me on iTunes, all that stuff is going down.
That's real. You might have to come to the building for that, too. And we will be there also March 9th in Ontario to check out that Lou Production show.
Exactly. Yeah.
Quick shout out.
Shout out to Lou Productions, Family First, CNT. We in the building. Yep. Shout out to the whole IE. Shout out to Blaze.
Yep.
We on, man.
Good luck,
that's
sir.
How we do.
Shout out Lou Productions, Double F and GRD, man. Y'all know what it is. Shout out my niggas, Retro 80s, man. We in the building, man. Y'all see us, man. We working. Feel me? That's what it is. Double F and GRD, Lou. All
absolutely. Right.
Let
him. All right. I want to thank you so much to the callers who called. And actually, there are like 4 people on the line right now. I'm not going to be able to get to you. We do have to finish at a certain time because this is going to be placed on the radio. Please, please call back next week. I hope to have a better system in place for the switchboard.
I think we got enough time to take a couple callers.
I don't think, I actually don't think that we do. So, we can try and take these callers if no O to the G.
They want to do that.
Oh, okay. You want to do a couple shout outs real quick?
Yeah, we want
to. Do your team, too. Let's go, Lou.
I just want to shout out Davida. Hey, girl, keep belly dancing. We love you. And Freddie Washington. Why am I speaking in English?
Demetra.
Mocha. All that, you guys. Just want to shout out our whole Loop Production Family First team. Love you guys. Thank you so much for supporting us.
Yes. Indeed, shout out Midwest Dayton, Ohio.
Yes, sir.
Loop Productions, St. Family Louis. First. Our stylist, Janie. Miss Mocha, Freddie, Davida. Everybody, we all love y'all.
Everybody in the IE, this is love. Love.
If you want to come on the show, come on the show, man. Hit me, man. You can get on the show, too.
Okay, let me see if I can pick up a caller, okay, since we done. Hello, can you hear me?
Press 1.
Hello, you're on the Blaze Indie LA show.
Hello, this is A1 Entertainment. And, I just want to shout out Family First Entertainment.
Yo,
hey.
They They got it cracking tonight.
All right. Good looking.
That's one of our affiliates that Willie Will brought on. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So. Good looking. Thank you. You anytime you want to come by the Blazing DLA show, just give us a call too, okay? Thank you so much. I'm going to try and pick up. Thank you. I'm going to try and pick up one more caller.
Hello?
Hello, you're on the Blazing DLA show.
Shout out to Lou Productions.
Hey. Love that support. Who's this?
My name is Sheree. I'm up in San Bernardino trying to find out when y'all going to be out here next.
That's where they're from. We're here. We're holding down, Sam.
To the east. Hey, Queen, Friday, late night spotlight, hard hitter boys. Friday, 114 South Rialto Ave. We doing it.
No, South Arrowhead.
South Arrowhead.
Got that. I'm looking forward to seeing you guys. You guys off the chain.
Oh! All right, guys. So let me just go ahead and see if we can do this. Center Stage Artist Showcase is going down May 4th in Long Beach. This is going to be a showcase that's going to have a $2,000 prize package, which will include a digital cover on the Hype magazine. It's going to have a distribution deal. I'm putting this together along with Tremaine Scott. More to come, but I just want you guys, please save the date, May 4th. We are taking artist registrations. Hopefully by the middle of next week, the site will be set up where you can go and register. So, and you can also buy tickets to come out. So it's going to be a massive thing. It's going to be really big. So I suggest, you know, you be a part of it before all the spots are taken. Center Stage Artist Showcase. Please follow me at LaShawn Turner PR. You can stay up to date with everything I'm doing there. I post everything there. And with that, we have to make this time limit for Urban Indie Radio LA. We're going to have to get into this track.
Shoot the O to the G. We always shoot the West Coast artists. This is Blaze Indie LA, and we're going to shoot that. DJ Quick, tonight. Yes.
Heck yeah.
Great show, guys. Great show.